Hello, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the HTTP 303 status code. The HTTP 303 status code occurs when a page has been temporarily moved. As a result, the server can't connect to the requested resource. Instead, you'll be redirected to a new page. Not only is this frustrating, but can also lead to other problems such as infinite loops or caching issues. In this video, we'll take a closer look at the HTTP 303 status code and show you how to remedy the issue. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what causes an HTTP 303 status code? The 303 status code simply indicates the result of a client's request. It's a greatly misunderstood status code because most users assume that it represents an error. In fact, all it means is that the server is redirecting you to a new location. Here are some of the reasons why you might see the HTTP 303 status code. There's been a change in the location of a resource. For instance, it may have been moved to a different URL. There's been a change in the way the resource is accessed. For example, it may not be readily accessible or publicly available anymore. The common occurrence of the server being misconfigured. There is a problem within your application. This typically occurs when your client application contains some custom code that's triggering the message. Typically, it's easy to fix the HTTP 303 status code when you know what's causing the issue. It's important to make a backup of your website. That's because some of these troubleshooting steps require you to edit your site's files, which can be a delicate task. You might also prefer to run these fixes in a staging environment first. Then, once you're sure everything is working, you can push the changes to your live website. To find out what's causing the 303 redirects, you can check the configuration files for your server software, looking for unintentional redirect instructions. However, first you'll need to determine which web server software you're using. Nginx and Apache tend to be the most popular options, so your server is most likely using one of these. Here, we'll show you how to check your configuration files for Apache. To get started, you'll need to access your site files. If your web host uses cPanel, you can access its file manager to do this. Alternatively, you can connect to your site files using SFTP. For this approach, you'll need to download an FTP client such as FileZilla. You'll also need your FTP credentials. With MyKinsta, locating your FTP credentials is simple. Just navigate to your dashboard and click on your website. Then in the info tab, scroll down to the SFTP SSH section. Once you've established a connection with your FTP client, locate your root directory, which is usually labeled public HTML. Then look for your .htaccess file. Next, open this file in a text editor and look for lines that use rewrite directives. A rewrite condition directive defines a text-based pattern that gets matched against entered URLs. If a matching URL is requested by a visitor, the rewrite rule directive that follows rewrite condition directives performs the redirection to the new URL. At the end of the rewrite rule, look out for R equals 303. If you find this value entered after the rewrite rule, you can try temporarily commenting them out. To do this, use the pound character prefix, then restart the web server and see if the 303 status code has cleared. Most applications keep some kind of server log where you can keep track of all activity. For instance, these server application logs can reveal which pages have been requested and which database results have been provided. Meanwhile, web server logs concern the hardware that runs your website, providing information about the health and status of connected services and the server itself. So you can try to resolve the 303 status code by finding your server log and analyzing its contents. If your website is hosted with Kinsta, you'll get access to these three types of log files in MyKinsta. Error.log. Specific errors, including PHP errors, are logged here. Kinsta cache perf.log. Cache error status for requests are stored here, like hit, miss, and bypass. Access.log. Here, you'll find all Nginx requests for the current day. To view these logs, you'll need to log into your MyKinsta dashboard. Then, click on WordPress Sites in the menu on the left-hand side of your screen. Now, choose the website that you want to view the logs for and click on the Logs tab. The first log file you're able to view is error.log, but you can use the drop-down menu to select any of the logs that you want to check out. Once you've chosen the log you'd like to view, you'll see a list of all the errors or requests that have taken place on your site. You can also use the search bar to search for specific text in the file. Plus, you can use SFTP to download the log to your computer. While accessing your server's logs isn't a solution in itself, analyzing them can help you figure out the issue that's triggering the 303 status code. Lastly, you may want to try debugging your client application. This option is best if there is some custom code in your application that's causing the 303 status code. To begin, make a copy of your site in a local environment. This way, you can recreate the exact scenario in which the 303 status code occurred. You'll also be able to view the application code the moment something goes wrong. To enable debugging in WordPress, it's easiest to use a plugin like WP Debugging. Alternatively, you can do this manually by editing your wp-config.php file. Again, you'll need to access your site files via cPanel or using an FTP client. Then, find the file in your website's root folder. Once you're in the wp-config file, head to the bottom of the file where it says, "That's all, stop editing." Then add the following code. Now you can view your site's errors by locating your WP content folder. If the debug was successful, you'll be able to spot a debug.log file that's only visible once WordPress has entered debug mode. You can download the file to view it on your computer and find the error that's causing the HTTP 303 status code. After that, you can disable debug mode by changing the values to false or deleting the lines of code completely. Kiss's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.